when I came to know that I have to teach simple working Gujarati to the famous, the magical, the honorable captain of England, Mr. Mike Brearley, I was a bit shocked, and apprehension also was there that will it be possible to teach such a great personality, because I am also a sort of a shy person and always keep low profile, and I have to teach this eminent personality. So how can I face him? But as soon as I met him in retreat bungalow for the first time, I found that he is as simple, humble and very, very unassuming person. Very simple. And he started his conversation with me, Namaste Sarup, like that. So immediately it was a sort of a connection with him.
Hmm.
I related with him. And he was a bit senior to me. So I was very comfortable. Okay, he is calling me Sarup. Okay. And I was calling him Mike Bhai. And that coined in whole Sarabhai family. So Gautam Bhai and Gira Ben and Mana Ben and all the servants and staff of Sarabhai family used to call him Mike Bhai. We started our classes in, I think, 85 during winter, December, January. So he used to come over here, so 1.5 months every year here. But in 86, he was here for consequently in December, January, as well as August also. So twice. And he was very particular about our classes, that he must, whatever time he found here, he must learn Gujarati, at least to be comfortable with Sarabhais and staff Sarabhais, all these things. I, as a technical grammar teacher, broke my rules, and I used to, I switched over to translation method, and sort of a my teaching to Mike Bhai was limited to household things, like how to say that I have lost my comb, please find out my comb, something like that, or I need orange juice, I don't like Mosambi juice, like that. So whatever he wanted on dining table, at breakfast time, at lunch time, at supper time, and sometimes going out with his family and in Manek Chowk or in Law Garden. So how can order food, and how can appreciate food? So we started like taste sour, salty, pungent, so all tikhu, moru, saras, bokharu, like that. So all these Gujarati table manners, Gautam Bhai used to say that teach him Gujarati table manners. It was a telephonic conversation, and nobody from Sarabhai family used to disturb us. Except after half an hour, every time a staff member would come and ask for my cup of tea or a glass of lemon juice.
How did he bring cricketers into the conversation?
He was a miraculous captain, I knew, because I am fond of cricket and all. So I was knowing that he is a great captain. So I was asking him, what are you doing now? As he was retired from cricket. So he told me that I am doing two things. I am a psychiatrist, so it was a surprise for me. And I do practice, and I am a counselor in London. And I have a inmate patients also. And upper story, it is my home. Okay, so that was a surprise for me. And what second thing he was doing? He was writing his famous book, Captaincy, at that time. So he was sharing me how he was doing counseling with Ian Botham, and all this episode was, he described me everything about Ian Botham and his problems and all. So then we started talking about Indian cricket. So Indian cricket, he used to give me his opinions about Sunil Gavaskar, and Prasanna and Chandrasekhar and everything. And every time he used to ask me that what is the meaning of these Sanskritized names of Indian cricketers. So either it was Prasanna, the happy man, Chandrasekhar, the name of Shiv, and Sunil, either sea or sky, blue sky, so like that. So he used to imbibe or absorb something about Gujarati culture, about Indian culture during his classes, and mood, food and mood, everything. So I think he was very keen. Not for a single day I found him that he is bored or this Gujarati lessons are imposed on him. Never. I never felt so. So it was, I think it was very motivating for me also, that this big person, how humble is he?
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.